Lovelies, it's me Sherry with Live Love Latte, and thanks for joining me for this collaboration video. Dana from Styled by Dana invited me to this collab. Hi Dana. And the other wonderful YouTubers on this collab are Wani from Wani's House and Shantae from Southern Girl Interiors. I'm already subscribed to them. I love watching how they design and decorate and put tablescapes together. So please check out their videos in the description box below. Dana challenged us to the $10 Hobby Lobby challenge. So basically, we had to go to Hobby Lobby, find something for $10 or less, and incorporate it into whatever we wanted to do. So for me, I decided to find something for my son's 16th birthday party. And because he didn't really have a theme in mind or chose one, I knew for sure he wanted a candy bar that's kind of like at a movie theater. So I went with the vintage movie look, and you can see the sign that I got here from Hobby Lobby. It looks like an old movie ticket. It says cinema, admit one. So I'm excited to show you how I put together a vintage movie candy bar for my son's 16th birthday party.
Here is the wood sign that I got from Hobby Lobby, and you can see even the ticket has a number. Good only, date sold. For the backdrop, I decided to put quotes from his favorite movies onto these chalkboard signs that are for photo booths, so they do have a stick on them. I also got those from Hobby Lobby, and I thought maybe a fun game would be to see who could figure out what movies these quotes are from and give them a prize. So here, you can, maybe you guys can figure out some of the quotes. This one says, "You gonna eat your tots?" And this one is, "I'm sorry, Dave, I'm afraid I can't do that." And then this is, "Roads, where we're going, we don't need roads." And the last one is, "Everything, okay, I'll talk. In third grade, I cheated on my history exam. In fourth grade, I stole my Uncle Max's toupee, and I glued it on my face when I was Moses in my Hebrew school play." So I'm wondering if you guys can figure out those movies. And no cheating, no checking on Google. And this is what the movie candy bar looks like. I think it turned out great. I used a lot of stuff that I already have. All of the chocolate and the candies are from the Dollar Tree, and the popcorn is just from the grocery store. These popcorn paper bags are from Hobby Lobby. I think there were a set of 8. So I got 2 packs of those because we're expecting about 20 people, including him. And then for the birthday cake, I just have my clear cake stand, a glass one, and these thin sparkler type candles from the Spritz line, I think it's called. Yeah, Spritz line from Target. And then this little banner also from Target, the Spritz line, that says happy birthday. And I just stuck it onto the cake. Now, this is not the cake we're having for his birthday. He's actually having an ice cream cake, but I went ahead and got this one because we are celebrating both Sicily and his birthday, so that will be something for our family. And then for the popcorn, I put it in this apothecary jar that's from TJ Maxx. And you can see here, this is a glass candle holder actually, and that scoop is from Party City, so they can fill their popcorn with that. Probably for the party, I'll already have some popcorn made up and into the bags already, so there wouldn't be you know, a lot of fuss here at the table. It's a lot easier for them to grab. And then back here, those are 3 small apothecary bottles in a tray that I use for our Alice in Wonderland tea party. And then those are just fake roses from the Dollar Tree that I had. And so you can see the color scheme is black, white, and that type of red. And so here on this tray is from my family room that I showed in my family room organization. I think I got this at Ross. That was a great price. I think it was like $9 or less. And so look at all the candies I got. I mean, it's hard not to grab some between now and the party, but you see the M&Ms, and I love that the Dollar Tree had stuff like snow caps and Raisinets, and then Goobers. You know, those are kind of old. I mean, we had those candies when I was growing up. So I just lined them neatly in the tray so that they can see what's happening. And I got about 2 each. The only thing that I got 4 of were the Hershey's cookies and creams. cookies and cream because that's my son's favorite. And then this wooden box with a medal in front of it, I thought went perfectly with the theme. This is from Ross, and then those tongs are from my brother from a long time ago. And then I've had these candy containers from Walmart. I've had those for years and years, and I usually keep stuff in there that I've used those for different parties throughout the years. And then here on the far right, I have these Charleston Chews red vines that I'll be taking out of the package, and these lemon heads. So these tins are from my laundry room, so that worked out. This is our ice bucket that I found at our local Savers, which is like a Goodwill. And then I just put the tall tin that's also from our laundry room onto a roll of tickets that I've had, and then also this cake stand. And I think I did it this way just so on this right corner there's some height, and I put height in the back, and that's why I put these candy jars also on that box. And then the apothecary jar, you can see, is taller, so just trying to put some height towards the back. And then lastly, in this front round one are these other candies like Good and Plenty, Junior Mints, some Wonka, 100 grand, I think, yeah, 100 grand, York and Twix, and this round tin with wood in it, and it does have handles, that is from Ross. So that is the candy bar that I put together for my son's movie theater candy bar for his birthday party, with the vintage movie look with tin and wood and apothecary jars. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and we will see you in the next one. Bye!
Thanks for watching LiveLoveLatte.net. You can also find us on Facebook, Twitter, Pinterest, and Instagram.